All right, hello everyone and welcome to Asia. It is Sunday, July the 9th, 2023. My name is Reese. I am an apprentice of the Master Trader, Inner Circle Trader, otherwise known as Michael Huddleston. I am an ICT student and or apprentice. I'm a Topstep partner. Please use my affiliate link in the description box below to start your futures combine. The following that you are seeing on the screen is a first effort here at an ICT bullish breaker. So that's going to be point A, point B, and then point C that pushes into liquidity, higher time frame liquidity. And I will show you where that is. So guys, price appears to be drawing at this moment lower to this busy undelivered portion of this busy down here, which is also internal liquidity. So that's what we're working on right now, guys. We're going to try and get long on the protracted phase or the time distortion phase. So basically, we're going to take a shot here at 25% of that busy. If the market wants to come down there, it might turn around before it gets to our buy limit. But I'm certainly not going to. I'm not going to get long at the market here. Okay, we've paired the low. We didn't make a new low. Yeah, guys, so from this point forward, the YouTube comments, you're all going to get the same answer. I'm kind of tired of answering them all. So I put in I made a canned response. I can copy and paste. Yeah, kind of got tired of answering them all. I've got to put in the work and actually watch the videos. Okay, guys, we're long one. Market is pushing further into that busy that it pushed to the midway point. Yeah, it did. So, all right, we'll see, guys. We're long only one, and the initial stop loss is going to go pretty far down. We're going to start scaling into a long here. Over time, guys, or we're going to get stopped out, and either way is fine. But this is ICT bullish breaker, so it's a low, it's a high, and a lower low that pushes into liquidity. So it's a decent spot to try along. Perfect, no. Okay, we re-delivered that busy. Re-delivered it. All right, let's get down on the 1 minute chart. So let's stay up on the 3 minute chart. I don't really want to be on the 1 minute. We're pushing into sell side liquidity pretty hard here, guys. So this could be a 15-point loss on one contract. That's a 300 loss. if the market turns around in our favor, I'm going to look for us to trade back through. Basically, I'm looking at that high. Okay? And we also have a little bit of a undelivered SIBI right there. That was ended up being a breakaway gap. So, you know, assuming that we're on the right side of the market now, we're on side long. That's what I'm looking at right there. All right, guys, that's what I'm looking at. Otherwise, we're going to be stopped out. But I was playing this as an ICT bullish breaker, so low, high, lower, low. And as you can see, we did deliver higher time frame liquidity. So 15-minute liquidity here. Then we also re-delivered a BISI that was over here. Now we actually even are pushing into inverted wick inefficiency. So it could turn around there at 140 evens if it wants to really get overzealous about it. I don't think that is the right time for it to push down to that 111.50 liquidity. I'll be Van Zan. Okay, this looks like it is going to be a loss, guys. So at which point we're going to continue waiting. See if we got any hope here. Yeah. At 140, so that inverted wick inefficiency, which is what, guys? You should, you know, if you're familiar with ICT stuff, you should know that's an inverted wick inefficiency. Could turn on that. That's a good candle there. Like to see it fill, re-deliver and rebalance that SIBI. Would be good. Just talking you through the price, guys. Okay. Looking good, looking better. Looking like we might be on the right track here. We were 12 NASDAQ points off. But I think that we got the right idea. I want to now come all the way back up to the yellow box. Come run up this internal high. Probably going to be a few hour long trade, guy. I mean, this is probably going to be a long trade. So, we're looking for a 35-point trade. It's probably going to be a long time. Okay, guys. Would like to see at this point, you see this little opening right there? That, I'd like to see that remain open. Okay, I need to be down on the 1 minute to see that. Okay, guys, like to see that purple box remain open, ideally. Gonna move the stop now just below that low. I'm also going to okay, we're long a second contract. And that's what we're working with, guys. I'm going to sit up on the 3 minute chart. I'm looking for that breakaway gap. See how this leg down was initiated with that breakaway gap there? I want to see the price now come back and come aggressively reprice. Well, I don't know about aggressively. I'd like to see it aggressively, but it's not really the right time of the day for that. So I want to see it come and reprice up to this SIBI, undelivered portion of that SIBI, so just above this. And I'm going to take my contracts off just before that. So we're playing it nice and safe, guys. We have good signs. So if you all see this purple box down here, Lord willing, that is a breakaway gap. And so I would not want to see price come and close back in the purple box, ideally. Although we might get a situation where it kind of, you know, trades all around it, kind of threatening it. So this is going to take time, guys. This is going to be a long trade, probably hours. Probably going to be hours. Okay, guys, I gotta go take a break. I'm gonna leave the recording going, okay? And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna annotate the 1 minute chart for you. Okay, guys. Those are my annotations. Microphone's going off, video camera's going off. I will be back later. I realize now that I had my microphone muted. Sorry. Okay, guys. First contract came on at 150 quarters. I took a partial here as I saw the, you know, this inverted BISI over here appears to be kind of providing some resistance. So we're going to leave one contract on for the full target, guys. I might add on a second contract if I see it kind of move in my direction. But I'm kind of familiar with what these things like to do, and they like, you know, it's probably going to come back, and so we'll play it by ear, guys. There's nothing wrong with taking parcels. So look, right there, 17 point trade, guys. That's a lot of people's daily wage right there. 17 Nasdaq points. It's a lot of people's daily wage. Sorry, it is. So I'm going to take it, guys. You will see me take parcels. I'm not trying to prove ego to any of you. I'm taking parcels, guys. I'm using risk management. I want to show you responsible trading. And, of course, I wanted to make it to my final target, guys. But, you know, all things considered, take parcels, guys. Just take parcels. Who cares? I'm not trying to prove anything to you. I'm trying to make money.
Hello. Hello?
Okay, we both know what the answer is before you ask. Today? No, bro. I need a little break from her. She was a little bit obnoxious last night, so. Bro, every good-looking dude that was around, she'd go right up, and then the other girl would pull her away, and I just kind of got tired of that. So. And of course, as soon as I said, "Hey, I want to travel and I want to do this and that," oh my God, she was like, "Take me with you. Take me with you. Why are you not t Yeah, and actually, the Cameroonian girl's mother also had a law degree. So Cameroonian girl, like, she's very smart, very intelligent, like really smart. Apparently, her mother is like an Amazon author, so yeah. So they were fun. I'm pretty sure, I am fairly certain that all that they were looking for the night was just to have a little bit of male company for the night. I do not think that blonde girl expected that she would actually, be interested. So, anyways. Yeah, I drove him home. So she went from about 100 to zero. She was real drunk and real excited. And then, right at the very end of the night, she was about to pass out. And I went, "Hey, you can chill here, and I'll take you home in the morning, or bro, it's not, believe me, it wouldn't be me hurting her. If anything, it would be me. It would be me in the box." Yes. I'm serious, bro. So, she was a wild child, yeah. A wild child. And she I guess apparently I asked her a little bit about the prior boyfriend, and apparently, because she was bringing him up, and I, like, repeatedly calling, how stupid he was, and like, "Oh my God, I've never talked to a dude that, seems educated before." And I went, "Oh, anyway, so, okay, so this was pretty crazy, right? I basically put her address in the Apple Maps, I've DoorDashed before, so I'm pretty good at getting to addresses." And she went, "Yeah, the last guy I talked to, he refused to use the navigation, and then we'd just get in a blazing argument get lost over it. I went, so that's the caliber of men that you've dated before, right? Is, yeah, so, you know, yeah, and I was like, all right, so you're really not used to dating an educated man, are you? And apparently the answer was no. I was feeling pretty good, yeah. Yeah, and so they, when they came back to the condo and they saw my, like, notepads and my yellow pads, they're like, oh my God, you actually, like, study and shit? And I was like, yeah. I'm like, I'm really, that is actually how I am. So I don't know if I'll still talk to her or not. She was immediately, like, wanting to marry me on the spot. And I went, no, we're gonna slow down here a little bit. Yeah, she did, but Cameroon girl was, she was, I get the strong feeling that she wasn't really interested, because every time that I'd be with the blonde girl, the other girl would kind of like say, hey, well, I'm going to go use the restroom, or I'm going to go away. And so they were obviously intentionally trying to get me to be alone with the blonde girl. So I think that was pretty much the intention. She was pretty cute and a lot of energy, but yeah, so you know, we'll see how that plays out. I'll definitely talk to her again, but I need a little bit of rest and relaxation, a little bit of recouping from that. You know, I'm not trying to rush into being a baby daddy or anything. No, I told her, like, yeah, I want to go to Australia, I want to go to New Zealand, and kind of want to, you know, build up my own income to be able to do that. Oh, and she was like, oh my God, I love you, please take me with you. And I went, all right, well, you know what, let's take this a little slowly, right, before we're slow down a bit. She's a project manager for some construction company down here.
I don't know which one.
Apparently she's doing pretty well for herself. So. And then the Cameroon girl was a pharmacist student, apparently. She was, yeah, very smart. So. Thank you, sir. Have you relayed my scornful messages to Harold and Cal in great scorn? Oh man. I'm about to be stopped out on this trade. Yeah. I did. All right, I got to focus on the market. I have work to do. Goodbye. All right, guys, obviously not the outcome that I was looking for. So we did take a loss on that. Okay, guys, we're down 300 on the session now. So, I'll tell you what I was seeing and what happened there. I thought we were drawing back up to this breakaway gap up here, and we ended up plunging through internal sell side liquidity here. So at this point, I'm not exactly sure what the market wants to do. I am going to remove the drawings and remove the executions. Going back down to one contract, guys. All right, so we are now down on the session, 350. We're down on the day. So we have work to do. This could also be ICT bullish breaker, low, high, low into liquidity. Um, I want to wait for more information, guys. I'm not very confident with the market right now. Was not expecting that outcome. Just to be honest with you, I wasn't. So, we're waiting now. Probably going to let this recording go for a long time. We have a low, high, lower, low. It's probably going to be worth another long, but I just want to wait on it. Yeah, that was pretty unfortunate, guys. As you can see, I do take losses. That's why I had the stop losses there, so we can reassess. That is not what I expected the market to do. That's what it is, guys. We took a 1K loss there, or 1.2K loss. Basically, I added on the second contract as we came above that bullish order block, and I thought I was going to aim for one standard deviation. We didn't have that. I'm going to give a long a shot here. Okay. We're going to give a long a shot. The stop loss is going to go below that low. And we are going to aim for the nearest liquidity. So low, high, lower, low. We're going to aim for that high right there. Okay. Stop is going to be at our invalidation point. Guys, I take losses. This could be another loss. Price, I did not expect this. I mean, guys, that was... I thought the market might come back down. I was not expecting it to do that. So it is definitely searching for liquidity right now. And if we get stopped out again, then we're probably looking at this. So, oh well, guys. I mean, we'll have to work our way back. We are now down 300 on the session. We were up like 300 or 600. Took a $1,200 loss. You're not just going to see winning trades for me. It sucks, guys. I don't like taking losses, but it is what it is. So if this trade that we're in now works out, it's because it's low, high, lower, low. That would be ICT bullish breaker. So that is that. If it makes a new low, then we're waiting, guys. We're waiting. Because at that point, the market should be coming all the way down here. That liquidity. All right, we're out, guys. We're waiting. Now we are definitely waiting. I'm no longer interested in what the market is doing. So we took another loss there. So let's add an alert on there. Let's add an alert right there. And let's get down to the 1 minute time frame. Let's see if price wants to make an ICT bullish breaker pattern. It is aggressively now repricing to liquidity, and so this thing could come down another 20 points. And unfortunately, it is what it is, guys. I am not I'm not gonna play this again. Not to the sell side. I'm gonna wait for more information. So, all right. I'm going to stop the recording there. You saw a loss, guys. The next recording is going to be Asian session again. Is what it is, guys. I'm now going to be waiting. Okay, waiting for more information. I want to see some sort of a reversal PD array. I want to see something. So we are now at a loss on the session of... So our max drawdown is 154, 187. So we've got work to do. We've got a lot of work to do, guys. Unfortunately, we just took some losses. So, all right, going to end the recording there. I'll be back with another live recording soon.